What's up, YouTube? Capital G here, D&O Commentary. This is my opponent. This is me. You can see I'm playing Shaddolls. I picked second because Shaddolls should always go second, no matter what you're playing against. Unless you're playing Cleese and you're not running artifacts, I guess maybe you should go first. In general, I would never go first with Shaddolls. It just doesn't make any sense. Looks like a mirror match. I've been running into a ton of mirror matches. Like, Shaddolls have been gaining popularity over the last couple of weeks. So, I wish I had my own mathematician, but unfortunately, I do not. Hopefully, I top deck a mathematician. That would be good. Maybe he'll go for Falco, like Squamata Falco. I'm about to add another, a third Squamata in this deck. I think I'm just going to go 41 cards and add a third Squamata in here. I've noticed all the Shaddoll versions are running three Squamatas, and sometimes I find myself running out of Shaddoll monsters. So, if Pot of Avarice was legal, oh my god, this would be the best deck if Pot of Avarice was legal. I don't even think it'd be a question. All right. OU Artifact Ignition. Not Artifact Ignition, Artifact Muratek. Trying to think what I want to do here. I don't really like my hand that much, honestly. Let's see. I don't think I want to go after his back row because it could be chainable. I don't have a way to get around Smuttertick. Mathematician without triggering it. I hate throwing fusions out there before my opponent does. But it is what it is. I think we're going to ditch these two. We'll make Dragon Chain Link 2. Okay, so we went plus. We'll get ourselves an artifact. I think Falco's looking, not an artifact, but a Shaddoll. I think Falco's looking really good here. We can go Falco. I guess technically I could, what's it called? I could, that wouldn't change my position. If I went Mathematician Pop and got my what's it? Actually, that's not a terrible plan because he'd have five cards. I don't want to give him six cards. Yeah, I don't think I want to give him six cards. Like, that's kind of a lot. So here's what we'll do. We'll do this. I'm not giving this dude six cards. So we'll do that. Pop this dude. Set. And there's no reason not to set the fusion, honestly. Let's just hope he doesn't have Shaddoll fusion. If he does, then you know, it is what it is. And also, I don't necessarily know what version he's playing. If he's playing the pure chaos version, or if he's playing like the artifact version. I mean, he can't be playing artifacts. There's no way he would have, what's it called? Oh, that was so awesome. Thank you, sir. So now we get to go plus. I think I'm going to leave Beast in my hand because I might need to use it sometime this turn. So, and I hate using it on Falco when I'm chaining it. What should I get? I'm thinking maybe of going Squamata. Yeah, I'm thinking about going dumping this and then getting Squamata to my hand. I think that's the route we're gonna go because it gives me a lot of plays. So get rid of that and keep it rolling. And he scoops it up. Excellent, excellent. Minimal effort win there. All right, so it's Shaddolls. I like to side out a little bit of my back row. I have a feeling he's running the Baby Dragon version. I love Vanity Emptiness. I mean, I love Vanity Scene in the Baby Dragon matchup. It is so good. Usually I side out my MSTs, Double Cyclone. Trying to think. I think I want to get a couple of breakthroughs in here. Or at least one breakthrough. I don't really love Felix in this matchup, to be honest. And I feel like one more card needs to come out. It's probably going to be a lore. Because Allure is just draw power, so I can easily side out Allure. Again, we just have to assume we're playing against the Baby Dragon version. Oh, he wisely lets me go first. Excellent. That's always, always, always the right play. Okay, so here's what we'll do. So, we'll go this, and we will take Falco, punch. All right, so we'll set these. I think we're going to leave Murotec in our hand. I don't really see a reason to set this card. You could say, like, the blind MSTs, but, like, everything I have is, well, two of the three are chainable. If he hits the evac, I would put my petition in my hand and just summon it next turn on his turn. But we're going to pass. We got our six cards, basically. We got our plus one. So it's on him. It's on you, dude. Just go. Okay, maybe our opponent died at the computer. That would be the... Okay, I was going to say, that's the epitome of anti-hype. Kind of feeling like he might go Dink Oseka. No. No, can't let you do that, Star Fox. Let's see. So he's going to take my mathematician... sure. So he is playing the, what's it called? So his mathematician will go off, and I don't really care about that, to be honest. So he is playing, the Baby Dragon version. I don't know what he's going to do with my mathematician, though. Okay, so he's going to dump Phalus. So we're going to evac my mathematician. And he's going to continue. And I'm just hoping that he can't really do anything with Phalanx. He says too strong. I mean, maybe he can't summon the Baby Dragons. He has no graveyard to use. So, like, what the fuck is he going to do with this card? He already committed his normal. It's not like he can tribute for Vanity Sphere or anything like that. Plus, I've got Breakthrough Skill anyway. So, again, my Mathematician I can use next turn. Oh, wow. He just passes? Sure. I probably should have used Sinister during the what's it called? I should have used Sinister maybe, but it's all gravy. It's all gravy. Set that. Normal this. We want some draw power. Okay. We've already committed our normal, so I don't really fear his Phalus. Like, what can he really do with it? You know what I mean? Ah, this was not a bad draw at all. Like, I don't think I'm going to try and do anything crazy here. I don't think that I'm going to go into the extra deck because I don't want him to come over the top with Shaddoll Fusion. And we're just gonna set a couple of cards. If he does anything that looks like he might nuke my field, I will obviously go Murotec, and we'll just kind of play it from there. So. And again, he can't summon the Baby Dragons. Like, that's the important thing. If he could summon the Baby Dragons, I would be a little afraid. I mean, I guess he could go another enemy controller. Okay, I don't care about this card at all, Mathematician. Like, I really don't care about Mathematician. Not in the slightest. So, we'll see what he's going to do. And I actually have two ways of triggering Murotec, by the way, because I can actually send a dragon and blow my Murotec up, and then I can, what's it called? I can obviously, what's it called? We will get rid of... that. So I'm going to go ahead, get rid of our mathematician on his side of the field, unless he has a response. If he has a response and he wants to do something with math, then obviously I'll just blow something else up. That's the thing I love about Murtek. Does not target. So I don't have to commit to any, like, he can respond with, like, L Shaddoll Fusion, and then I can just blow up whatever the fuck he summons from L Shaddoll Fusion. So, like, he basically is forced to do his play. Okay, so he does. And let's see what he's going to do. If I was him, I'd probably try and attack the Falco. He's still looking at his extra. I wonder if he plays Gores or not. Okay, so he's playing L Shaddoll, or he's playing the regular Shaddoll Fusion. Equips Wyvern and Hedgehog. We got to start counting those darks, basically. Okay, so Equips Wyvern has to be one. Construct has to be two. And then, was it Hedgehog? It has to be three. I think it has to go exactly in that order. Because Equips Wyvern is super mandatory. So I think it's only one target, just Dargon Dragon. But again, right as of right now, unless he has baby dragons, he has no way of summoning said Darkon Dragon. Or I guess he could have BLS, whatever. Alright, so there's Dark Arm, Construct. And then he has Hedgehog. So he's gonna get on Beast. Okay, cool. Cool, cool, cool. What's he thinking? Core is going to activate, and unless he's not going to activate Core, I thought he'd activate Core and just get his Fusan back. Yeah, I thought he'd just activate Core and get his Fusan back. So, he does have, obviously, the big beater on board, which sucks. Mathematician. Let's count his darks. Alright, so he's clearly trying to nuke the field once again. Alright. So I'll do that, basically. Semi-Dragon, blow up my Murtek, and get rid of his Phalus. This way I still get to keep my Mathematician. So he gets Construct effect, obviously. He can't use L Shaddoll, I mean, he can't use Shaddoll Fusion anymore, because he already used it this turn, so. He says you're raping me. I mean, the artifacts are just, they're very disruptive cards. And the big thing about this is he can't get any value out of the Mathematician. Like, what's he going to do with the Mathematician? He obviously, I mean, this dude he's been trying to nuke my food. He's been trying to nuke my field with Black Rose, like, since turn one. And my Murtek have been, they've been stepping up and basically thwarting everything that he's been trying to do. So I didn't want to have to trigger my Murtek that way, but, you know, pretty much it is what it is. So we're just going to get rid of this broad, and play will be on him. He can obviously attack the Falco. That's what I would do. He only has two darts, too, by the way, so it's not like he can drop Dark Arm, even if he somehow gets it to his hand. He can't even drop it. So he attacks that. Don't care. Really, really don't care. Let's see. I'm trying to think. I think we just go straight up YOLO. Alright, so normal summon dragon, there's like no reason not to. Okay. I think it's 1950, if I'm not mistaken. Getting in with, what's it called first? Yeah, I didn't attack with the second Murtet, just the first one. Because I want to get damage in. So, attack with this dude. I just wanted to get one Murtek in and then leave the last one for core. Because, I mean, he pretty much has to use it. Unless it's, like, super poly in his hand or some shit. Okay, what is he doing? what are you doing, bro? Like, you took the two attacks. Now I'm attacking with Squamata. It's 1800. If he flips over core, then obviously I'll just attack with what's it called? I'll just attack with Muratek. Okay, so attack with dragon. Okay. So Muratek will now attack it. And he gets nothing. Alright, so the odds of him having two Shaddoll fusions are not high at all. I wish I ran another, what's it called? I gotta find a way to get Digusto Emerald into this deck. It's gonna get there. I think I'm gonna take out Michael. I haven't made Michael in forever. I haven't made Armades in forever too. That's another card that is probably gonna come out. So Palladies I actually do make on occasion. So, let's see. I'm trying to think. I think I want to send my mathematician to my hand. Yeah, we'll send mathematician to our hand. Just so that at the very least we can, you know, set up like a Falco play or something like that for our next turn. Okay, so he just scoops it up. I guess he didn't have any plays. He wants a rematch. Let me finish saving this one first.